Hey guys, today we're going to talk about perspective. Perspective is the way you see something, but it's also how you see something. How you see depends on where you are, your position. Let's look at this mug. When I change my position, I have a different perspective on the mug. When I change my position, the mug looks different to me. From one position, I see the mug has a rainbow, but I can't see what's inside. From a different position, I see that the mug is filled with tea, but I can't see that it has a rainbow on it. When I have a different perspective, I get different information and I know different things. If I only look from one position, I only get information from that perspective. So your position affects your perspective and changes the information that you get. Everybody has a different perspective because everybody sees things from a different place. If you want to go get an ice cream because you're so bored at home, but your mom or dad says you cannot, you have different perspectives. You want to enjoy it. You want to have some fun. You want to get some sugar, but your parents are thinking about your health or money. Your parents are in a different position than you, and they might see things that you can't see. You see things differently. So you have different perspectives. Right now, living is hard because we cannot easily change our position. We can't hang out with our friends or go to the movies or see our families or go to school. Our position has limited possibilities. A possibility is anything that could happen. There's a possibility it might rain. There's a possibility my friend will call. There's a possibility you could become a millionaire. There's a possibility I may become one too. There's a possibility you will become an engineer, a doctor, a consultant, a lawyer, an artist, an entrepreneur, a designer, or a chef. There's also a possibility that life will never go back to normal. Life is always changing and it's full of possibilities. A limit, on the other hand, is a boundary. It affects how much you can do and how much is possible. This is a limit. This is a limit. This is a limit. This is a limit. And this is also a limit. Limits affect our possibilities. But right now, our government is also limiting us. The government has different limits for people, often based on their skin color. When the government allows different people different limits for the same action, or when it gives different possibilities for different people for what they can do in a society, this is called inequality. I think inequality is wrong. My perspective is that inequality is wrong. Many people today and all throughout history have fought and died to show us why that inequality is wrong. Racism is used by people in power to limit our positions and therefore our information and rights based on our skin color. America is a country that was founded on racism. Racism is very complex, but basically it's a way to trick someone's perspective on reality. When white people have wanted to build their own wealth, they have created a false perspective by telling lies about Africans, Native Americans, Islanders, South and Central Americans, and Asians to justify enslaving us, exploiting us, killing us, and disregarding our humanity. Then, white people in power of business and government have created laws to deny education, safety, health, and quality of life for people of color, forcing us into situations where our positions are limited to prove their point that we are stupid, lazy, ugly, dishonest, and dangerous. And then pretending that they didn't do anything. If it sounds crazy, that's because it is. Racism is a way to completely distort our perspective on power. Because our country was founded on racism and bloodshed that has never fully been acknowledged, racism is completely a part of the fabric of American society. Racism can be obvious, but mostly it's very subtle. We have to work very hard to see ourselves beyond the perspective of racism. We have dark skin and we are powerful, intelligent, and beautiful. Racism tries to destroy us by limiting our perspective. limiting a person's ability to act in society based on their body, whether it's their skin color, gender, body shape, height, sex, sexual orientation, or body type is wrong. They try to control our perspective of ourselves, but we do not have to be limited by other people's perspectives. Right now, we are stuck to communicating inside computer screens. The computer screen forces us to have one perspective, like a window. All of our information passes through this one window. Let's use technology to change our perspective. Artists make things to help us see our lives from a different perspective. You are entitled to your own perspective and to change it. When you empower yourself, you decide how you want to see yourself and see the world, and you give yourself more possibility. You can empower yourself by learning more information to change perspective. The more you empower yourself with information, the more possibilities you have. You will. And the more control that you will have over your own life, I promise you. We have the power to change how limited we feel by changing the perspective of ourselves and of the people who we care about. So guys, here's your assignment. Draw a picture or make a video of something in your home from three different perspectives. It could be a thing, a person, or an emotion. Show three different sides to it. And here's some questions to answer. How does your position affect your perspective in your home, in your family, or in this country? When is a time where you felt a limit, and what caused this limit? What is your perspective on yourself? How do you see yourself? I look forward to seeing your answers and to talking with you guys on the internet. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and please don't hesitate to ask any questions. Have a great day, and I'll see you on the internet.